morning, good afternoon, good night, wherever you're watching this from. Welcome to Assem Live. This is Assem Sports. Bright, beautiful, sunny spring Tuesday. We are still hung over. We are still recovering from the ripple effects of the Emirates FA Cup that went down this weekend. History was made. A classic is an understatement. A cracker, maybe bazooka, lived up to his billing and more. Thank you for tuning into Assem Sports. We're talking about the Emirates FA Cup quarterfinals that went down this weekend. Still, we are still high from the action and exhilaration. Manchester United against Liverpool. What a way to send us off into the international breaks. As many of you may aware, the Premier League and all major leagues across Europe are taking a back seat for international duties, national duty requirements, where teams are playing in the Euros, but also qualifications in the CONCACAF in the Americas. So the Emirates FA Cup was the last major game, last major piece of action that football soccer fans got before the international break. And oh, was it a fairy tale for Manchester United. It looks like all is well with Erik ten Hag in terms of the new ownership and Ineos consortium, Jim Ratcliffe. That is a season turning game, if you ask me. The performance, it's not about just winning and losing, it's about how you win and how you lose, like I always tell you guys. And the way Manchester United had their backs against the wall, but they were able to find a fight, they were able to grasp some grip of gravitas. And just the Kobbie Mainoo performance, the young kid of Manchester United, a rough season, but they are projecting slowly but surely towards the right direction. Thank you for tuning in to Assem Sports. We are still talking Emirates FA Cup. Premier League was pushed to the back seat heading into the international break. Chelsea was also in action against Leicester City. And unlike Manchester United, where you can pinpoint players who are able to define a game, even for the dying minute, for a young kid, the Diallo kid to come, if you watch that game, Liverpool had that game in the back. And for them to lose a little bit of focus, but it takes pressure. At a point in time, you could tell Manchester United were tired too, but they had the willpower. The Diallo kid being able to get that ball under pressure for Conor Bradley. And it wasn't the best of kicks either. His execution wasn't eloquent, but he found a way to put the ball in the back of the net. That is what matters most. Winter season is where true champions are made. Like I always say, the fourth quarter is where you show character. And Manchester United have shown character. Chelsea, on the other hand, if you take Cole Palmer out of this Chelsea team, I keep telling you people, and it's not like I'm just trying to be harsh, but the truth and the facts are there for everybody to see. The tasting of the pudding is in the pie. If you go back and watch the tapes, I don't just talk about the game. I speak from an empirical, statistical, but also athletic point. If you watch Chelsea games, the game that Cole Palmer didn't play well, we lost, or it was a draw. Cole Palmer, I mean, the game against Leicester City, where Chelsea were leading 2-0 at half-time, 89th minute, it was 2-2. I mean, how if you watch the game, you know the comedy of errors that caused those goals. And missing penalties and missing, so Chelsea is still not away yet. Mauricio Pochettino still doesn't know his constant 11. And you can get lucky, but how many times can you get lucky when Cole Palmer is not on form? Even Zidane wasn't Zidane every day. Cole Palmer cannot be on form every day. He's not a superhuman. So a kid as young as that, when we have experienced players in the team, if everything falls on Cole Palmer, sometimes it won't work. Then who is going to save the team? So Mauricio Pochettino, I hope he's just saying the right things, the politically correct things in like press conferences. But behind closed doors, he's being harsh on these players because some of these games should be buried and done. Thank you for tuning in to Assem Sports. What is your evaluation of the Premier League so far during this international break? Man City is still the team to beat. They are sitting on top with, let's see the standings. Thank you for tuning into Assam Sport this beautiful sunny Tuesday. Man City is still sitting on top. I think Arsenal is the big team. Arsenal is the biggest team now in the Premier League, but Man City is still the team to beat. Champions League is also going to go down when international break returns. Those set of games are just mouth-watering, worthy of the final itself. The Arsenal-Bayern Munich clash has become popular among the football soccer fans. I mean, the Man City Real Madrid is the one, if you ask me. I mean, there's no way around it. Arguably the two best, not even arguably, Real Madrid and Man City are the two best teams in Europe now. People can make an argument for Arsenal, but you see, the Champions League is a different. If you watch Arsenal, they've struggled in the Champions League games as compared to their domestic Premier League games. That there's a certain level of extra edge that comes with the Champions League that if you've been there before, it gives you an upper hand, as we saw with Borussia Dortmund and PSV Eindhoven. I feel like Arsenal, maybe if they want to win the Premier League, they might have to sacrifice the Champions League. I don't see them doing both. Manchester City is still the team to beat. They are playing against Real Madrid in the quarterfinal. Arsenal is playing Bayern Munich. Barcelona is also in action against PSG. Dortmund is playing Atletico Madrid. Lots of games are going on during this. After the international break, Euro qualification games, like I said, are happening. We will keep you informed as they reach our desk. Have a wonderful week. It's been a splendid weekend of football where it was all about the Emirates FA Cup. Which teams do you tip to finish top four? Actually, top five, because the Champions League next season, if you know, they've changed their criteria in terms of group stage games. So I think five teams are going to qualify from each domestic league across Europe. We're going to talk more on that tomorrow, talk more about the Euros. Thank you for tuning in. Have a wonderful week. Like you already know, the Forecast 1.0, new Assam music collection available on all platforms. Click the link in the bio. This is Assam Sports. Over and till. With a channel coming soon.